Earlier in Boston, the Canadiens eliminated the Bruins, and in the post-Game 7 handshake, safe to say this is not Milan Lucic tailing Dale Weiss. Hey, bud, good luck against the Rangers. And again, Yemelin, he's probably not asking him to keep in touch during the offseason.
We said that you had some stuff to say in the handshake line. What did you say, and why would he say that?
It's set on the ice, so it'll stay on the ice. So if he wants to be a baby about it, he can make it public.
A lot of them had a lot to say about disrespect, that from the flexing of the water, that they were motivated by that, and they felt that fueled them. What do you think?
Disrespect? I don't know what they're talking about, disrespect. Having a goal celebration, what kind of disrespect is that?
I can't believe I shook this guy's friggin' hand after the game. That pisses me right off.
A 12 game. Artemi Panarin and Kucherov. Not the best of friends, but there's a hug.
On the far side, Lewis out there on this line, brought back in. Kopitar got away. Kopitar shot and a save made. Jammed in and a goal. Great follow up. You got to go after the puck, and that's exactly what Gaborik did. Kopitar had the initial chance, and they followed it into the blue.
Finally gained traction as the series went along.
And Marian Hossa is in the same picture as last year.
Penguins a little late to get to the handshake after the celebrations, and that's the reaction of the crowd you're getting there.
3 days ago, some were still bothered by Pens captain Sidney Crosby not shaking hands with every one of the Detroit players, including Nicklas Lidström, the Wings captain, downplayed the snubbing.
It's a big tradition in our game, and we're all, you know, I think you all should do it after a series, so... You know, I think he just got caught up in that moment.
That's one thing you should do after a series. You shake hands, and I don't know why he didn't do it. I think it's disrespectful. I don't know the reason why he didn't do it, but I hope I had a really good one.
It stood out on the handshake line that you and Martin Brodeur did not exchange pleasantries afterward. Did that surprise you? What'd you think about that?
Well, everyone talks about how classy, unclassy I am, and Fatso there just forgot to shake my hand, I guess, so.
Did you think by watching that again, or by being there the first time, that he had that in his mind from the start?
I don't know.
It's been a tough week for him, we know that. He's handled it like he's handled everything in his career with a tremendous amount of class, and the Penguins are showing some class themselves now, coming over to say goodbye.
One way you want to become public enemy number one is do this. They're not going to appreciate it. I'm sure McElhinney didn't appreciate it either.
The Carolina Hurricanes are going to the Eastern Conference Final.
number 33, Henrik Sedin. And number 23, Alex Edler. Time of the goal, 2:33 of overtime. Daniel Sedin, his 23rd of the season from Henrik Sedin and Alex Edler at 2:33 of overtime.
Well, there's the guy that everyone's going to be talking about, and these players will certainly be wishing him the best of luck in a tough decision he'll have to make. I mean, if this is to be his last game as a Detroit Red Wing, everyone that's a fan of the National Hockey League will certainly miss him for sure. He has brought some unbelievable magic, hence the name the Magic Man, to the highlight reel shows on a nightly basis that we had so much fun watching and adoring such a talent.
A rare night in professional sports as Ryan Smith heads to the bench and back out onto the ice for his final salute. And the Canucks are coming back onto the ice as well for a ceremonial handshake led by their captain, Henrik Sedin. What a terrific sporting gesture here tonight.
Now that's cool. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that other than when Wayne Gretzky said goodbye to the National Hockey League under different circumstances.
But right on.
Show of class by the Vancouver Canucks. Exceptional. Exceptional sportsmanship right there.
For the Canucks, with one game to go tomorrow at home against Calgary, pay their farewell and show their respect to a great hockey warrior in Ryan Smith's curtain call here tonight.
Congrats, Smitty. I met you when I was 10 at Sorrentino's.
The Ottawa Senators are proud to select the Sénateurs d'Ottawa, sont fiers de choisir, from USA Hockey's National Team Development Program, Colin White.
There's a lot of pedigree in this family. Like I say, he's going to a Boston College. He's compared to Patrice Bergeron.
We usually have the handshake. It'll be interesting to see what the guys have determined to do here based on the conditions, social distancing, and all of that.
Well, the Rangers are lining up as if something's going to happen. They're doing the elbow bump here with the Ranger and Hurricane coaches. You can get a handshake in there.
Yep, that's what they'll do. Fist bumps. And the great tradition of hockey will continue. It's good to see. What a season for Mika Zibanejad and the Rangers. They're in the neighborhood, just 2 points back of Carolina. This is a team in the Rangers they thought rebuilding. Not much of a chance. You see the great Henrik Lundqvist and Bush. You wonder what lies ahead for him, right?
Yeah, you really do. I mean, you feel for him. It's been such a great career. And sometimes these situations happen where a guy comes from underneath and makes it difficult. It'll be Jeff Gordon's got his hands full with what he's going to do with that situation.